If we take the Earth and shrink it down to the size of this beam, voila, we have a black hole.
Black holes are the remains of supermassive stars that warp space-time so much that nothing can escape it, not even light. That's why black holes are the only place in the universe where we can see things behind us, but not in front. But what are black holes really good for other than just gobbling up matter? Well, they are a whole lot useful. Firstly, it is no coincidence that almost every galaxy has a supermassive black hole at its center.
The shape of the galaxy depends upon the presence of the black hole, and the speed of the rotation of the stars around the galaxy depends upon the mass of the black hole. All of this provides more than enough proof that there is some sort of relationship between black holes and their galaxies.
To understand this better, we need to go back in time to the formation of the first stars. These stars were really massive as they were made of pure hydrogen and helium. So they died quickly and left behind supermassive black holes. These black holes had two phases of their lives. One, the quasar phase, in which they fed on the small group of stars or incomplete galaxies, and due to their enormous gravity, brought together the stars, forming the first galaxies. Then they would enter into the dormant phase, giving time for the galaxy to create many more new stars. But can't the stars just come together by themselves? Do they always have to rely on a black hole?
To answer this question, we need to understand the two forces acting on stars. One is their gravitational energy, which causes them to come closer. The other is the expansion of space-time between them, which causes them to move away from each other. Since the gravity of the stars alone is insufficient of getting them close enough to form galaxies, only black holes with their enormous gravity can bring together all the stars, thus forming galaxies. Black holes not only form galaxies, but also establish their stability.
Take for example our own Milky Way. It has the black hole Sagittarius A star at its center, and all the stars revolve around it. If not for it, the stars would collide with each other, resulting in huge turmoil. Black holes can even hold galaxies together, resulting in the formation of clusters and superclusters, both which are very much essential for creating a closed environment. Else, the matter would escape into deep space, being completely useless for the universe.
It is astonishing how something as small as singularity could affect the universe in such a weird and mysterious way. Indeed, even though they destroy, they create, sustain and coordinate various systems, without whose presence, the universe would definitely be a different place.